Hey everyone, my name is Mohit. I'm a developer evangelist here at Salesforce. In this video, I'm going to show you how to successfully retrieve org metadata using Salesforce CLI and packages. This technique is useful if you are moving away from org-based development model to source-driven development. Source-driven development uses Salesforce CLI and scratch orgs or sandboxes that have source tracking enabled. I've installed Salesforce CLI. You can install Salesforce CLI by visiting developer.salesforce.com/tools/sfdxcli. I've also created an org. It's a developer org where I have deployed all the metadata that we have created for one of our sample gallery apps, Easy Spaces. You can visit the URL trailhead.salesforce.com/sample gallery and take a look at the metadata that we have for this specific application. I've also installed Salesforce extension pack for Visual Studio Code, which you can obtain from Visual Studio Code Marketplace. I've also scaffolded a project, an empty project, using the command palette and by using the command sfdx create project and selecting the standard template. I'm also connected to the developer org where I have all the metadata and I'm authenticated to that. So in the org, I have lots of metadata. I have classes, I have permission sets, I have custom objects, fields, and all other metadata that's part of this Easy Spaces application. I want to extract all the metadata to my project workspace. And the easiest way to do that is by creating packages. So you go to Package Manager and click on Package Manager and New, and then provide name for the package. Now in this case, let's say I want to say Easy Spaces as my package name. Now, important thing to note here is you have to make sure you add the top level metadata element so that all the dependencies for that specific application is pulled once I add this metadata to this package. So for example, if I add a space management app, because it is the top level metadata and it has all the dependencies to different fields, objects, permission sets, you will see that once I add the metadata, it will bring all the dependencies in this specific package. So all of the dependencies are automatically retrieved. And that's the property of a package. Now note that we are not going to upload this package. And if you delete this package, it doesn't mean that all of these metadata will go away from your org. You are free to delete and create as many packages as you like. It's just an unmanaged package, which essentially is a container holding all this metadata. Now let's see how we can retrieve this metadata to our project workspace. So Salesforce provides command called sfdx for source retrieve command to retrieve your metadata. You can do a help on this command and it will show you different variations of the commands that's possible. Now, because we are retrieving the metadata from the package, you can follow command sfdx for source retrieve and provide the name of the package. In this example, my name of the package is Easy Spaces. So I go ahead and provide the name for that. And once I run this command, this will pull all the metadata in my package to my local directory. Now, once the package is sort of retrieved, you can see all the metadata in a folder named with the package name, and you can see all of the components of that package. So, unmanaged package containers are really a good way to understand dependencies between the component. It can be a playground to create packages and find dependency between different metadata and retrieve them locally. So for example, let's say I want to pick up one of the classes like customer service and I want to add to the package. It will not only just pull up that class, but it will also pull all other dependent metadata that this Apex class has, like customer fields. Like for example, we have custom fields and we have Apex class, we have the page layouts. So all of these are interdependent, so we can do that. Now the thing about this command is you can also retrieve multiple packages. So it's not just only one package, you can retrieve multiple packages and those will be retrieved in multiple directories. So all we will have to do is make sure that we provide package names as comma separated list, and then we can retrieve multiple packages right within your project workspace by using this command. Now, oftentimes we do not sort of remember this command, and it takes some time to get used to typing these commands. So Visual Studio Code provides something called as tasks.json. So in your .vs code directory, create a file called task.json. I will share this file with you in the description section. So this file I created just to show you an example of how to use task.json. So I have the command to retrieve the metadata sort of written with arguments, and then I bind the input so that we can run these commands without having to type them. So let's see how to run them. So to run them on your Mac, you'll have to type Command Shift B. On your Windows, you will have to type Control Shift and B. So say Control Shift and B, and you will see the same command that we have in the task.json sort of listed here, and you select them and then you enter the package name. So for example, in this case, my package name is Easy Dependency. So I just enter them and then say enter, and it will run the same command in the terminal without me having to type this command. So anytime I enter Command Shift B, I'll get an option to execute the command with the inputs that I provide. So as you can see, there is another folder sort of created with all the metadata elements sort of retrieved, and the folder name is equal to the package name. You can use the same technique to retrieve metadata from your managed packages or unlocked packages or chain sets that you have built in your org. Now, if you have also built customizations on top of a managed package, you can also retrieve those metadata by collecting them inside the package and then retrieving them by using the package name as shown in this demonstration. I hope this video gave you a good overview on how to retrieve org metadata using packages. If you learned something, be sure to like this video. If you want to get more content like this pushed directly to you, click subscribe and that bell to get notifications.